Hello friends, under Company Law 2013, as we are doing the topic of the Article of Association, so today our topic is the alteration of the Article of Association. Alteration means the changing the provision of the Article of Association, and it's written out there available at my blog. First of all, we will see the alteration of Article of Association is governed by the Section 14 of the Company Act. A company has its statutory right to change its Article of Association, and any regulation which derives this right is invalid. For example, there is a provision in the article that no alteration of the article is possible without the consent of the someone. Then it is contrary to the provision which are contained in the Company Act, so it is invalid. A company cannot replace its article. Only the regulation which are contained in the article could be amended. The company can alter its article by way of something adding, by way of something deleting, by way of modification, by way of substituting something, or any other way only if it wants. What is the procedure of alteration? By passing a special resolution. Special resolution means 75% of the vote, they should be favored in the alteration of the Article of Association. A copy of special resolution has to be filed within 30 days to the Registrar of Company. Every alteration which is made in the Memorandum of Association or Article of Association shall be noted in every copy of the Memorandum of Association or Article of Association. If there is a default in complying with the provision, then the company and every officer in default will be liable to a penalty of ₹1,000 for every copy of the Memorandum of Association or Article of Association which is issued without such alteration. The altered article will bind the members in the same way as the original article. For altering the Article of Association under Section 40, the company has to basically check the provision which are contained in the memorandum. Then it could alter the Article of Association as the provision of this act and the condition which are mentioned in the memorandum. And then the company has to pass a special resolution, alter its article, including the alteration which is having the effect of conversion a private company into a public company or public limited company into a private company. When a private company is converted into a public limited company, then it has to alter its article that they no longer include the restriction and the limitation, and the company ceases to private company. Any alteration which is having the effect of conversion of public limited company into a private limited company shall not take effect unless it has been approved by the tribunal, which shall make such order as it may deem fit. What is the procedure to alter the Article of Association? The company has to convene the board meeting of the director as per Section 173 and Secretary Standard 1 by giving notice of at least 7 days. And at the board meeting, the date, time and venue of the extraordinary general meeting is fixed, and the 21 days clear notice is given. And the general meeting, extraordinary general meeting is held at the appointed day, and special resolution is passed. Special resolution means 75% vote should be in favor, and then there should be approval of the alteration of Article of Association, and then the company is required to file form MGT 14, filing of resolution and agreement to the registrar along with the requisite filing fee within 30 days along with the copy of the notice and the certified true copy of the special resolution along with the explanatory statement, also a printed copy of the altered article. Alteration of the article under the order of the National Company Law Tribunal as per Section 241 and 242. The tribunal may order a company to alter its article with a view to resolving complaint under operation and mismanagement in the company on the application which is made under Section 241 of the Act. When the alteration is made by the order of the tribunal, it will have the same effect as it is made by the company in accordance with the Act, and the company is required to file a certified copy of the order with the registrar within 30 days of the issue of that order. Now we'll see what are the limitation on the power to alter the articles. A company can alter the article of association at any time by passing a special resolution. But this right is subject to certain limitation. The alteration must not be against the provision of the act, like an article cannot authorize the company to pay dividend out of capital. The memorandum of association is a supreme document and the article of association is a subordinate to it. So the provision of the article cannot supersede the provision of the memorandum of association. Like in the case of Halton versus Scarborough Cliff Hotel Company, a resolution was passed at general meeting of a company. They altered the article by inserting the power to issue new shares with preferential dividend. The memorandum of association was not having such power, so this alteration is ineffective. The alteration must not contain anything which is illegal, and it should not be prohibited by the memorandum of association. And it should not be consistent with any alteration which is made by the tribunal under section 404, where an order under 397 or 398 make any alteration in memorandum of association. An article of association should not be inconsistent with the order by the tribunal, except with the approval of the National Company Law Tribunal. And basically, no alteration can be made in the article which has the effect of converting the public company into the private company unless such alteration is approved by the article. No alteration can be made in either the memorandum or article compelling a person who is a member on the date of alteration to take or subscribe for more shares or increase his liability without his consent. Alteration of the article will be made only by special resolution, which is defined in the act. Special resolution means minimum 75% votes they should be in favor of the changing of the articles, and it should not cause any breach of the contract, like in the case of British Murex Syndicate versus Alpershan Rubber Company Limited. There was an agreement so long as the X company should hold 5,000 share in the Y company, the X company have the right of nominating two director on the board of Y. The Y company made an attempt to alter the article, but it was stopped by the X company getting an injection because it was the violation of the agreement with the X company. The power to alter the article must be exercised bona fide for the benefit of the company as a whole. If the alteration is bona fide for the benefit of the company as a whole, the interest of some shareholder may be sacrificed. Like in the case of Allen versus Gold Reef West Africa Limited, the article gave the company lien on all the shares which are not fully paid up for calls which are due to the company, if any. A was the only shareholder who was holding the fully paid up shares. He owed money to the company for call outstanding on other shares. A died. The company altered its article by deleting the words "not fully paid up" and gave itself power to exercise the lien on A the shares. And this alteration was for the benefit of the organization. Fraud on the minority must not constitute a fraud on the minority. The power of alteration must be exercised in good faith in the interest of the company. Like in the case of Brown versus British Appraiser Wheel Company, the majority which was held 90% of the shares passed by special resolution that upon the request of the holder, 9/10 of the issued share, a shareholder shall be bound to sell and transfer its share to the nominee at fair price. It was considered to be invalid. Retrospective alteration means the alteration which is effective from the back date. The alteration of the article may be altered as to have retrospective effect, but alteration should not be such as to increase the liability which is more than the contract date. The article cannot be made unalterable, which means that there cannot be any provision which says that article cannot be changed or modified. And the alteration should not be done in such a manner that it will result in the discrimination between the two groups.